What's up? How you doing? Today I'm gonna be putting this fuel pump in this go-kart. Pretty sure the bracket for that pump is in this middle bucket here, which can only mean one thing. Aha! I can't believe I'm saying this, but I think this might be pretty simple. Weld that, clean this up, weld it, put the pump on, and run the hoses. Yeah, what could go wrong? I've been lucky with the fuel tank up to this point. The only thing I've caught on fire is myself, so I'm just gonna remove it before I start welding this time. Finally ready to run some fuel lines in this thing. Now we have our right bar up here. That's the one that's connected to the fuel line that goes to the bottom of our tank. So that's where we're gonna be sucking fuel out of. So the fuel's gonna come out of here, get ran through a filter, and it's gonna go into the intake side of our pump. It's gonna get pumped out here, and that's gonna push that fuel up to the carburetor, and that's what's feeding our engine. Now attached to that line, we're gonna attach a T-fitting, and we're gonna run a line that goes from that line all the way over to this left fitting, and that's gonna be the overflow. So any of the fuel that the engine's not using is gonna get returned back to the tank. Now we have this line here, which is called a pulse line. And the way that works is it gets attached to the backside of the carburetor, and as that piston's going up and down in the engine, it's creating pulses of pressure, which are gonna get sent down here to the pump. And this is basically a diaphragm pump, and those pulses of pressure are moving that diaphragm, pumping that fuel through the pump. Fuel lines are in. I'm going to be replacing all these anyways. They're all cut to the right length, except for this guy here. I'm going to extend that, and that'll let this hose drop down to that one, and everything will be nice and tidy right along the bottom there. I'm going to be finally attempting to fire this up. It's going to be loud. Dang it. And on that note, I'm going to dinner. See you in the morning. You didn't think I was gonna give up, did you? Up and run, so I guess I didn't mess anything up too bad with the fuel line. We got fuel to that engine now. We need a way to control it with a throttle pedal, and we also need a way to stop this thing with the brakes. So this is the original contraption off the Soty cart. It is very complicated, so I'm just gonna start going through this, dissecting it, and trying to figure out how we can make it work for our little Power Wheels go-kart. Things got chaotic really quickly, so I'm gonna spend some time, get this cleaned up, and then we can see what we're working with. Cause somehow we gotta turn this pile of parts into usable pedals for our go-kart. Much better, I'm not gonna lie guys, I have been staring at all these parts for about an hour now, trying to figure out how in the world I'm gonna be able to fit them in here. Still have no idea, but what I do know is I wanna throw a little floor plate in here cause that's where your heel's gonna be sitting. And then my foot's gonna have to come up and it's gonna have to clear this little steering linkage here. So I'm thinking, I'm gonna weld a piece on like this, just enough to clear it, and then the pedal's gonna sit on top of that.
Of course, to get those plates in, fuel tank's gotta come back out. There's a couple things we need taken care of before we tack in those plates. There's a couple gashes in the frame that I'm gonna weld out. Those were from when I was cutting apart the original go-kart and cutting the brackets off. Then also this joint, and then that far corner joint need fully welded, and then we'll get those tacked in.
I got the field lines in, so I was able to extend that tube up there, and I got everything cleaned up. Got those two floor plates in, they're looking real nice and real good. Got the fuel tank back in, and I was able to extend that one line, so that dropped all the other lines down, and that cleaned that up. I might have to do a little something with the pedals. I might have to reroute those, but that'll be for the next one. Thank you guys for watching. If you're enjoying this build, hit that like and subscribe button, and I will see you on the next one.